Hello, good day everyone. Today we are going to talk about the concept of D-value and Z-value in controlling growth of microbial spoilage.
So here is our group members, which are Hanisara, Khairunisa Azahra, Nur Sabrina, the fourth one is Sangari, the fifth one is Nurul Ain Najwa, and the last one is Nur Akila.
What is D-value and Z-value?
D-value is the time required to reduce the number of microbes by one log, which is 90% reduction in population. By looking at the graph, y-axis represents log value because microbes are present in a huge number on any food sample, whereas on x-axis is time. From the graph, we can point out that at after 50 minutes of exposure, the population was still high, and after continuous exposure, the population is less than before. Z value is the number of decrease the temperature has to be increased to achieve a 10th fall. And according to the graph, A is at 120 degrees Celsius, and to bring it down to B point, the temperature has to be 125 degrees Celsius. That means the temperature should rise by 5 degrees Celsius. The smaller Z value, the greater sensitivity of the microorganism towards change in temperature.
Factor affecting the growth of microorganisms in food.
Factors affecting the growth of microorganisms in food is divided into two. First is intrinsic factor, where we have pH, volatility, redox potential, and nutrient. The next factor is extrinsic factor, that we have temperature, relative humidity, and gaseous environment.
So here is the food type that we choose, which is meat patty. The processing methods of the meat patty includes modified atmosphere packing, freezing, and curing.
How microbes contaminated meat?
So, how microbes contaminated in meat? First, fresh meat has a high water content. This is favorable for the growth of microorganisms. The volatility of meat is higher than 0.9, which is the highest volatility in food. It also generally contains bacteria, including those that can cause disease to the human body. Without we realize, equipment and tools used in the process of meat can also become contaminated with microbes and spread to the raw meat. pH. In a normal living mussel, the pH is approximately to 7.2 pH, which is neutral. Then, glycogen will break down to lactic acid when mussel turns into meat. So, the pH of meat usually range in 5.2 until 7 pH, where is low acid. For the temperature factors, bacteria usually multiply rapidly at temperature from 4 to 60 degrees Celsius. The spores of some pathogenic bacteria, such as Clostridium, are not easily destroyed during high temperature or cooking. The heat of cooking can activate those spores to germinate and develop into mature bacteria.
So next is survival factors. Survival factors is an ability to form spores ensure survival under adverse conditions for long periods. Later are only rarely encountered in fresh tissue. It is also highly resistant to heat, chemicals, and desiccation, and therefore they can germinate and convert to a fully active vegetative cell. As we know that Clostridium are resistant in meat patty, we also must know that Clostridium resistant to solvents which are alcohol, enzymes, detergents, and disinfectants. For environmental stress conditions, they are resistant to heat, ultraviolet light, and ionizing radiation. And for the growth temperature, It is between 3.3 to 80 degrees Celsius, with optimum between 25 and 40 degrees Celsius. Next, D value and Z value in food industry. D value and Z value both are important in canning. D value gives the time needed at a certain temperature to kill 90% of the organisms, while for Z value, it relates the resistance of an organism differing temperature. Thus, both are important in canning process. That's all from us. Thank you.